With the hydro pipe laid and covered up in the woods, the building team are installing a tube to take all the cables from the generator to the house.
What are we doing with the pipe?
I've got to cut it, put it in the ground there to extend that one that's going to carry all the cables and the pipework from the solar and the hydro into the basement.
We just fish through, yeah?
Yes, we can fish all the pipes through later.
Hello.
Go that way a bit more, Paul, up tight up there.
This lawn they are digging up is kept pristine by a robot mower as long as its boundary wire stays intact, which is what Kerry and Sam are searching for as it's being cut.
It's the wire that stops the lawnmower going up, Mike, the lawnmower going any further. The digger driver's not very good and just cut through it.
It's got to be.
Could be back up here. We're just pulling grass up for a living.
Whilst the boys try to find the ends of the wire they've just cut, I'm heading to Kai's office as Juliet's garden designs are in. With only 10 months until we're meant to open, I want to see what my dad thinks of our garden plans.
You want to sit down?
Yeah.
And the idea is, because what a lot of what we're going to be doing is based on the elements, fire, earth, air and water.
Okay, yeah.
So you're going to have these these streams of planting which sort of mimic the waterfalls and the streams. Yeah. This is the terraces, yeah? At the front.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, you can see the ribs, yeah.
This one comes and represents air, and then this represents the fire, which sort of wraps around
so
that fire.
So what's all
pit.
The blue stuff, yeah?
This is planting.
Okay.
So this is all plants.
And this is just, this is a pathway, is
that's
it?
That's a, yeah, crazy okay. paving pathway through it.
What's the plan scale on this?
The time scale?
Yeah.
June, same.
Wow.
I know.
That's crazy.
I know.
Are the volunteers going to be doing most of the work here? Or are you going to get specialists?
In terms of the planting, I think we've got quite a few volunteers who know a lot about plants and are really interested.
Okay.
So I'm hopefully going to have two permaculture people come. So permaculture, that's more about the growing of the food. So if we've got some people here who come and do some workshops with the volunteers and stuff, then absolutely, I see no reason why the volunteers can't be a big part of all the planting.
Yeah, it looks impressive.
It's cool, isn't it? I mean, that's just around the house. But then, yeah, moving down into that main field beyond the first fence.
Yeah.
This will be a big fruit tree orchard. It won't be as regimented as that. It'll be much looser.
Yeah.
And then this is all the solar panels. But we're gonna hide them as much as we can for the neighbours' benefit. To be honest, for us, I'm a bit like, this is part of the story. This is what it takes to be green.
Yeah, I was going to say.
So this will all be surrounded by planting.
And when would this be put in, the solar panels?
Don't know. Kai?
We need planning to sign off on it before we stick the order in.
I see.
You don't want to order all those solar panels.
No. What's the scale of costs for this?
About 150 grand.
It's overwhelming, the amount of money that's involved.
I mean, to be honest, like, when I first bought the house, which was all the money I had left, I thought that this was going to be £500,000, basically, that I could do it and I could finish the house for £500,000. Now it's turned into, basically, a £1.5 million project, which is totally borrowed money, which I think is probably terrible financial advice, but I'm going all in.
OK. I think, yeah, I would go all in, I would.
And it has worked out well for you in the end. You have to work your ass off, though.
Yeah.
That's the bit that's...
As long as you don't ask me for any money, yeah.
No, I need your money. I do. You've already offered it anyway.
I was drunk. Jeez.
So whilst I'm trying to find the money for this project, Kerry and Sam are still on their hands and knees looking for the boundary wire for Mike the mower.
And now he's got no boundaries, he'll just be wherever he wants to go. He'll be escaping, yeah, and we don't want to escape because he's doing
last time we found him in Shrewsbury.
Such a fantastic job on the lawn. So okay. Now we'd just be finding the other part of this wire.
It's like looking for a needle in a haystack, man.
Give you a tenner if you find it.
All right.
Yeah. Now I'm just... Oh, wait, here we go.
Got him. There we are, turn back down.
I have to pay myself now.
Sean, bruv. Hold that in one hand.
This goes wrong, Mum. I love you.
My mother told me to do it.
No, right, yeah, my bad.
So I'll go and get through crimp, through crimper together, put some amalgamating tape on. I'll just leave it like that for now. Paul can carry on there now.
Well done, Kerry and Sam. All that's left is to cover up the pipe to the hydromill. I adore our pastures and woods here, so I'm hoping to build some eco-lodges for guests to stay in. I'm visiting a venue just a few minutes away for some inspiration. And with my stress levels through the roof, I'm having a little bit of a holiday too.
Back to the Shire, young Frieda. Come on.
The second breakfast is.
Really nifty, cute little space. Reuben Dexter will be tonight. This is really cool space. All beautiful built wood. And then this is us with this beautiful bath.
Owners Ben and Gemma have been open for a few years now, and it's going so well that they're building more hobbit houses.
Oh, wow. Is it a lot of work to excavate?
One time it was like 3 quarries here, wasn't it? To dig it all out, to put it all back in.
Really?
Yeah.
So it was sort of all open and then you make the structure and then you put the...
Put it back in, yeah.
Because there is a spot where we could do a similar thing, which is by the stream. It looks so awesome. I mean, obviously I don't want to... take your business model and do it 5 minutes away, but no, they look so beautiful, don't they?
Yeah, no. We find holidaymakers like something different.
Yeah, even though you're only 5 minutes away, there's so few in the country and they're that popular, it wouldn't matter. It would be good. It'd be good for the area anyway, wouldn't it?
Very magnanimous of you there, Ben. What's sweetie pies?
The living area / eating area so that you've neat your food, relax whilst looking out the view that we've got.
I mean, it's a pretty amazing panorama. And what about your price range for this area?
The Hobbit houses on the bottom, which are between 270 to 290 per night. And then these ones up here, which are more luxurious and have a few more luxuries in them, they go into the £300 per night bracket.
Sounds a lot, £300 a night. But when you've got 6 people,
yeah,
it's not so bad per person.
Yeah.
These do still need planning permission, but it would be much cheaper than what converting the barn would have cost.
Where do you want to go? You want to go and see the moo cows,
don't you? Can you see the cows in the field?
Do you want to go and see the moo cows? Oh, come on, let's go and see the moo cows.
This is definitely something worth thinking about. In the meantime, my dad, Ruby and Dexter have also come for a nose.
Who is he? Who is he? Say Dexter!
It's a great idea.
It's good, isn't it?
Have you thought about doing this?
Yes.
You've got this on the hill. It's an ideal situation.
Yeah, over the stream.
Are you going to see the cows? Are you going to feed them?
Whilst Ruby and Dexter take the baby to see the moo cows, and Frieda embraces her inner punk...
Yeah.
Cows.
Dad and I have a catch-up while setting up the Barbie for later.
I'm thinking about getting one myself, but I'm going to have to take out another mortgage.
To get one of these? Wow.